going to do one more poem, and it is a short one, and there's a reason for this. This, I think, if people are entrepreneurs and in local business here, this is just a promotional piece, more or less, about a business that I found to be superb. The change in my wallet seemed to be under constant attack on all fronts. $5 to get on a bus, 10 for some bite-sized sandwich claiming to be a lunch. Booking fees and membership fees and transfer fees and holding fees and T's and C's and student fees and joining fees. Jesus, please, these people are robbing me constantly. I log in to see my bank account and it's rarely a feeling of victory. So I feel it's worth paying tribute to a shop that used to do a well-priced box of sushi. You may be able to get by on a student loan or the benefit, but there's a financial advisor somewhere out there who needs to rewrite the small print and cut the word live, because there's not much life in bread and mince. We were students up at Vic and still privileged in the sense we could go back to mum's and dad's fridge. Most don't have that luxury, and a budget at 50 a week is unlikely to be a subsidy for the finer things in life. We trekked down at 4:45. Half price started at 4, but they'd make more than enough to last till 6. And we are talking chunky bits. Massive lumps of fish, avocado, wasabi, mayo, and shrimps. 50 cents a piece, $4 bought you a feast. The small side street of the CBD was packed out routinely at 4 o'clock for Sushi Bi. And while it never excluded the afterwork suits, it seemed a different sort of person could pull on their boots and come out for the discount food. And I tell you, when every businessman and his dog seems to want to rob you, the weight of that 4 o'clock, $4 box felt like a small victory each day. My mind doesn't really work in business and digits, but in those last 2 hours, they simply couldn't have been making a profit. And the cynic might say it's offsetting losses on leftover product instead of bin bagging it while building customer loyalty with discount marketing tactics. And maybe so, but it doesn't change the fact that the less money could still fill up a bag with proper food. And I refuse to believe they did those last 2 hours for the money. Rather, some good person somewhere stood up and asked the question, why shouldn't poorer people occasionally have prawns? And it dawned on me. It dawned on me when Sushi Bi expanded into 3 places around the city. Maybe compassion is the key ingredient to capitalism going right for once. And thousands of people getting a reasonably priced lunch is something that matters to me. I have never seen hospitality treat the small change patron with any sort of dignity, with the exception of Sushi Bi. And that's something they can be proud of, perhaps more than their broadsheets and GDP. It would be all poetry to say you can't put a price on a small victory, but you can, and it's $4. In a world of typically shit food, with prices hiked up through the roof, I wanted to show my appreciation. And I think I speak for that winding line stationed down the street who at 4 o'clock, you pulled out all the stops to feed. Good people meet good people halfway, and that there's good people out there was all I felt the need to say. Thank you.